So hello everyone, I am going to explain you the plantae kingdom and the division gymnosperm, okay? So as we have already discussed that in plantae kingdom, there is a sub-kingdom, two sub-kingdoms are there, phanerogams and cryptogams. So phanerogams are flowering or seed-bearing. So gymnosperm is one of the member of phanerogams, sub-kingdom and division gymnosperm. So it has generally, when you come to the features, then you will observe that it is generally originated in Mesozoic or Jurassic era of the history of human evolution and plant evolution. So gymnosperms name given as they are naked seeded plant. So first features we have to study the naked seeded plant. No ovary, no fruits, ovules are uncovered. So all are the same things. You any point you can remember. It has near about 900 species, yet 500 of them are conifers. They found in like a cone in region where the snowfall taking place. The features is Sequoia regia. You are familiar with Sequoia regia is the tallest tree yet known, 116 meter height is given to the Sequoia regia. Okay, so like the pteridophytes, they have also sporophylls, which are of two types, microsporophylls and megasporophyll. Microsporophyll bears microsporangia, which are compactly arranged. Microsporophylls are compactly arranged to form the cone. And there are male cone, microsporangia give rise to male cone, while megasporophylls compactly arranged to give rise to female cone. Each one is called microsporangium, and here microsporangium, here is megasporangium. Microsporangium produces microspore mother cell. These all are diploid as they grow from zygote the seed, which are diploid. So plant body is here, sporophyte, that is the dominant phase is diploid phase. So microspore mother cell still is diploid, which undergoes reduction division here, then form pollen grains. Okay, these pollen grains further produce male gametes and which fertilizes by the with the help of wind. In megasporangium, that is also called ovule, the megaspore mother cell will produce, which is also diploid. These all are diploid. Here reduction division takes place to form the egg and a pollen grains, the male gamete of pollen grains, the egg fertilize. Fertilization taking place after pollination through wind, and a zygote is formed. This zygote undergoes further division to form embryo, and embryo to seed, which is uncovered. That seed germinate to give young plants. Now vascular bundle, other features. Here you must remember that VB means vascular bundle, have no vessels, unlike even pteridophytes and gymnosperms. Bryophytes have no blood vascular or blood vascular system, vascular bundle system or vascular system. So bryophytes, there is no question. In pteridophyte, vascular bundle, and gymnosperm also vascular bundle, but have no vessels. Vessels is the characteristic feature of angiosperm. So, यहाँ आपको ये this thing you have to remember that the vascular bundle in gymnosperm without vessels, but in angiosperm they are vessels. Pinus and cycas are the example. These are the frequently asked question in medical that in case of fungi, here fungi is there, fungi together with the pinus tree, they form a symbiotic relationship that is called mycorrhiza. So this is important, very important things you have to understand here, that mycorrhiza is nothing, it is the symbiotic relationship or the infection of fungi with the pinus root, very important, never forget it. Cycas, so coralloid, these coralloids are nothing, these coralloids are the again symbiotic relationship
of the cycas with blue green algae. Here BGA means blue green algae. So when blue green algae makes symbiotic relationship with cycas, it is called coralloid. When the fungi combine together, make a symbiotic association with Pinus, then it is called mycorrhiza. Both are for N2 fixation strategy for plant. Okay, they have a tap root system, because they are the totally they freed from the water, no water, so all adaptation taking place to make them adapted to live on terrestrial habitat or xerophytic, means where there is a scarcity of water. Cycas, Pinus, Cedrus, Neetum are the examples you must remember. Unlike bryophyte and pteridophyte, the gymnosperms have no independent gametophyte. They have I will explain later on. Persistent leaves, the leaves remains retained for the year, many years the leaves are found, so they are persistent leaf. They have thick cuticle and sunken stomata, which help them to extend even in a stressful condition when there is a scarcity of water. So these all are thick cuticle and sunken stomata are the xerophytic condition. They survive in even a scarcity of water. Now, try to understand here the life cycle. This is the example of, you are observing the example of gymnosperm. It's a very ornamental plant, generally people's plant in their pot or at your home or in the school, it is already available. So this type of plant you might have seen, this type of roughly cylindrical, they have a stem, tap root is there, planted in the pot, the stem is there, these are leaves are cone-like, needle-like leaves to reduce the loss of water. And at maturity, after passing the juvenile phase, it bears two type of compactly arranged structure known as female cone and male cone. So this one is a male cone, this one is a female cone. Here are the sporophylls, compactly arranged sporophylls, which are megasporophyll, producing megaspore mother cell and megaspore cell. Or here is the microsporophylls compactly arranged to form male cone, and they produce the pollen grains. So pollen grains are produced in male cone and eggs are produced in female cone. With the help of wind, the pollination taking place. So here you can see in life cycle, this is the sporophyte, because it is germinated from seed. Seed is a diploid, so seed germinate to form a sporophyte after passing the juvenile phase, vegetative phase. It undergoes reproductive phase, means flowering phase, where it bears the male cone and female cone respectively. Male cone bears the microsporophyll, female cone bears the megasporophyll and megasporangium, and megasporophyll bear megasporangium, microsporophyll bears microsporangium, in which the diploid, all are diploid because they develop from zygote. So microsporangium gives the microspore mother cell, which are also diploid. Microspore mother cell, here you have to understand, microspore mother cell undergoes reduction division to form pollen grains, and pollen grains give male gametes, which fuses with the egg. Now in megasporophyll, megasporangium, that is called ovule, which is also diploid, megaspore mother cell is also diploid, which undergoes reduction division to form egg, and these egg and the male gametes further fuse to form zygote give rise to embryo is developed into seed, but the seed is uncovered, the seed is not enclosed in the fruit. So it formed the seed but not fruit. This seed again after dispersal germinate to give young sporophyte. So here you can observe that up to pollen grain to zygote. So this is the gametophytic generation. This one is the gametophytic generation. From this one, pollen grains to zygote. So it's a very short leaf. When you compare the gametophyte generation, it is very short leaf, as well as it is dependent upon the sporophyte. Unlike the bryophytes, in enteridophytes. In bryophyte, pteridophyte, the food seeds are capsule, or even in pteridophyte, the sporophyte was dependent upon gametophyte, and sometimes gametophytes were independent too, in prothallus. But this is not the condition here. The totally gametophyte, these are the gametophyte, totally dependent upon this sporophyte. So in this way you can easily describe. So this structure, these all long-lived is sporophyte generation, that is diploid generation. And the short-lived is gametophyte generation, that is haploid generation. So in this way you can easily explain the life cycle of and few features of gymnosperm. Very common, students generally confused to understand because in NCERT this figure is not given. So if you explain, if you understand with the help of this figure, it will, I think it will very, very helpful to understand the features and all through flow chart, you can easily systematize the knowledge. Thank you.